Hey everyone, friends, I finally got around to testing hair cinematic tool 2.0. I won't talk too much. I recommend watching their video on the page. I'll leave a link to this tool in the description and pinned comment. I decided to test it on my project, which had a lot of issues. For example, blurry details, ugly shadows that didn't work well, and also there were issues with DeepShadow. I tested a ton of CVars, but couldn't fully resolve the problem, though I sort of found a partial solution. Still, the render quality wasn't what I wanted. I didn't feel like tweaking all the CVars commands. I shelved the project and waited for improvements in new Unreal Engine versions. Hair Cinematic Tool helped find the perfect solution. First, their tutorial explains how to set up scenes. The cool thing about this tool is that you just drag a blueprint into the scene, and it gives access to a bunch of CVars commands whose parameters you can tweak like an offline renders. Look, I'll show you the render result. Here is what I got without PPLL rendering. See, how does the result differ? First, there's PPLL rendering. When you enable it, the quality improves significantly. First, hairs and light reflections render much better. You can see the difference, higher quality. If you toggle it back and forth, I'm not sure if you'll notice, but the difference is obvious. These parts render more clearly. Like that. There are some nuances in my hairstyle. For Unreal, it might need a bit of tweaking. In Arnold Render, these issues weren't noticeable. Bald spots weren't visible in that render. Hair rendering works differently. But the render quality in Unreal got better. Thanks to Hair Cinematic Tool, I set everything up as they advised. It's all explained in their tutorial. First, I configured post-process volume. You'll see all this in their video, which they show. In UE 5.6, the parameters have slightly different names. I adjusted exposure compensation. You also need to set up global illumination. Set it to Lumen, then change ray lighting mode to the right value. There are many such details. Set Lumen scene lighting quality to maximum. Make sure to enable screen traces. Turn off megalights. I recommend doing this, otherwise you get issues with hair. Enable Advanced Lumen. Add Sky Atmosphere and SkyLight to your scene. In SkyLight settings, enable Cube Map. Also adjust Intensity Scale. I increased it for better hair response. Turned off! Cast Ray Trace Shadows as they're not needed. Select Disabled. In BPH Hair settings, disable Hair Duff. It doesn't work very well. Make sure to enable SuperSampling Deep Shadow. Set Deep Shadow Resolution to 6K, since my GPU can handle fast rendering. It'll run a render and show you how long it takes. Set Voxel Density Scale Transmittance to 7, as they recommend. Ray Matching, Stepping Scale 1, MSAA, samples 8 or 16. I chose 16. For the viewport, you can use a lower value, depending on your GPU. With my GPU, it runs smoothly with these settings. I can show you without issues. Switching to perspective, everything rotates smoothly. I zoom in, inspect. No problems with RTX 5090. The scene renders as is. Change the deep shadow resolution right away. By default, it's set to 124, I think. The quality is low at that, or maybe 248, I don't recall. I set it to maximum. The quality improves dramatically. See the difference? Shadows become sharper, better for hair, body, everything. In SkyLight, disable lower hemisphere and lower hemisphere. Solid color. To see SkyLight in the viewport, you need to enter a command. It's explained in their tutorial. You can see HDRES. Now you can see why disabling lower hemisphere is necessary. The result is much better with it off. Like that. With this command, you can tweak parameters and see changes. You need to find the right lighting and choose the right angle. Also, set the lighting intensity correctly. For example, at 1 it's too dark, but at 10 it's fine. The result is better, and hair reacts to lighting immediately. If you set intensity to 1, I don't like the result. At 10, the hair responds better to light. In BPH here, check the skylight settings. Enabling or disabling it shows the difference right away. With it, the quality is higher. I set it to uniform. They recommend ad hoc, but it depends on the scene. I like how hair reacts to uniform in this scene. By default, hair doesn't react at all. The quality is worse. Let's take a look. First, it'll show the renders. Hairy's how they turned out. The hair looks pretty high quality. I'll also show movie render queue. The project already has a preset. I tweaked it a bit. Based on experience, I disabled anti-aliasing, setting it to none. They had temporal super resolution enabled. For static images, these values usually work better. For animations, DOEF and such, set it to 8 or 16. I arrived at these values experimentally, and Epic Games recommends them. In CVars, I increased screen percentage to 105 and set the output to 4K. I mostly followed the settings from their tutorial. Thanks to that, the quality turned out great. Later, it'll show for rendering in a separate video. For now, let's test with these settings. Maximum cinematic quality. Select Config, Save, and Confirm. Click Render local and time how long it takes. One frame takes about 35 seconds. Let's see how long a 16 frame animation takes. Here's the result. It's clear that manually setting parameters takes too long. With Hair Tool, you just move sliders, and that's awesome. Plus, Hair Tool comes with additional scenes. First, a model to test settings, and additional scenes where you can add your character and render. In the Argentum folder, there's hair, look, dev, load their preset map. The world, that is, it'll look dark at first, but don't worry. Add skylight via the lights menu. And sky atmosphere via the visual FX menu. In skylight, make sure to select spherical cube map. The standard one works. Increase intensity, but 10 is probably too much. I left it a 1. You can remove the default head or use it as a reference. I want to render my own character. So I remove the default head, groom, and all related objects. Then the groom folder, and the character itself. You'll be warned about potential sequence issues. Ignore that. Drag your character in mine is MetaHuman Cooper. I've already saved his hairstyle. Lift him to fit the frame as needed. For rendering in this camera. In the Hair Look Dev folder, there are lighting presets. Here's one lighting setup. It'll load now, or this lighting setup. The next preset looks like this. And after that, like this. You can use these presets. And then render. Using their settings, which I find convenient. Of course, you need to tweak skylight and sky atmosphere. In BPH hair settings, you'll need to adjust some parameters. So the defaults are already set up, as needed. The parameters are already in place, basically, so you don't have to stress about it. PPLL is enabled, everything's great. Just increase MSAA, and you can render with their settings. Adjust the character's rotation in the sequence, and so on. Before this review, I recommend watching their video. I just showed a test and how I solved my issues. The main thing, I finally got a high-quality hairstyle render. And I'm happy with the result I achieved. With these settings, it's all very simple. Just move sliders, like in an offline render. If that's all I wanted to show in this video, thanks for watching. Follow the link, buy the asset, and watch their video, and enjoy the rendering process in Unreal Engine. Guys, if you're looking for awesome 3D hairstyle references, I recommend the website 3D.sk. The site has two categories, Groom 3D scans and Groom photos. There aren't many scans yet, but there are plenty of hair photos to start working on a hairstyle for your character,